Hello everyone, welcome to our 12th lecture. This lecture is based on Clark diagram for two machine system with a resistance. In earlier lectures we have seen two machine system with losses is complicated by the fact that sending end power is greater than the receiving end power. Also it occurs at different angular separation. This we have seen, and the stable angle depends upon the relative inertias of the two machine as well as governor action. This we have seen. Finding out steady state stability limit of a two machine system with losses is complicated. We can find out steady state stability limit of a system by synchronizing power coefficient by finding out the synchronizing power coefficient. If it is greater than in case of multi-machine system also, if synchronizing power coefficient, that means partial derivative of P1 with respect to del 1, partial derivative of P2 with respect to del 2, if it is greater than 0, if it is positive, then the system is stable. This same is applicable for multi-machine system. Okay. Now, in Clark diagram without losses, we have seen that angle between del 1 and del 2 is 90 degrees. Okay, so here with losses, that means resistance, we are considering that angle. Also we have seen that is not 90 degree. Okay, that means it differs from 90 degrees to a smaller value equal to theta 12 or 180 degree minus theta 12. We have seen in positive resistance and in negative resistance. In positive resistance, that angle is del equal to del m2. Okay, the smaller value which we are considering. Okay, that and this limit we are calling it as a conservative one. In case of negative resistance, that angle is lying between 90 degrees to 180 degrees. Okay, so the smaller angle we are considering. Okay. So now in this we'll consider again two machine system, same only thing is that here resistance is included. Okay, that means Re plus JXe. Okay, this is reactance of first machine, reactance of second machine, machine 1, machine 2, even internal voltage of machine, terminal voltage of machine 1, terminal voltage of machine 2, internal voltage of machine 2. Okay, now we'll see vector diagram or Clark diagram of this system. Now how to draw the vector diagram or Clark diagram of two machine system with resistance. Without resistance we have seen, with resistance we'll see now. Okay, now this we can consider this horizontal line is our reference vector I. Okay, now first step, you know, lay of segment IX. Okay, that means IXE, IX1, IX2. Okay, so we will start from receiving end. So this is, now for this we have to consider scale. Okay, whatever value given, then 1 centimeter is equal to 0.1 unit, 0.2 unit, according to your convenience you can take in example. Okay, so this is our IX2. Okay, then IRE. Now here you can see that as it is resistive drop, IRE is a resistive drop, so that drop we have drawn parallel to our current vector. Okay, so this is our IRE. Okay, this is our IRE. Then IXE equivalent to the values given in the example. Then IX1. Okay, so we have layoff segment IX. Okay, that means IXE, IX1, IX2 and IRE. Okay, that RE drop, this is important, that IRE drop we have drawn in horizontal, which is in phase with current vector I. Okay, this is important thing that we have to note, and this thing is differing from the Clark diagram of two machine system without losses. Okay, now this is our first step, that step is over. Second step is join this A and first last point and first point. Okay, join this A and E, then draw the perpendicular bisector of that line, that is F. Okay, now extend this CD and it will intersect at G. Okay, so what, join the AE, draw perpendicular bisector, this is our second step. Third step, with G as the center, draw an arc. With G as the center, draw an arc. Okay, so now third arc we have drawn. Third step. Now fourth step, you know, it is locus of V1, specified values of V1 and V2. This locus ratio V1 by V2 should remain constant. This you know already in lecture 7 and 8 we have seen how to draw this locus V1 and V2. If you are not getting again, then refer the lectures which are on YouTube specifying or telling how to draw Clark diagram or how to draw this V1 by V2. Now this V1 by V2, okay, specified values of V1 and V1 by V2, this ratio should remain constant. Okay, now this will intersect this and this will intersect at point O. Okay, now from this you have to draw E1, E2, V1, V2 and Vm. Okay, it is in phase with I. Okay, so it will touch to this line. Okay, this is our Vm and I is in phase. Okay, this is maximum. This is, and by this, by maximum steady state stability limit, we can find out by Vm into I. Okay, so fourth step is draw locus of V1 by V2. Then next step is join E1, E2, V1, V2. Sixth step, you know. Now this you have to convert into voltage scale or power scale. This you have to convert into voltage scale or power scale. Okay, then that scale you have to apply here because this is given in unit. Okay, what are values? These are in centimeter that you have to convert into the voltage, that we have to convert into the voltage. Okay, then last step is this Vm we have to find out an I. How to find out I? This is seventh step. Finding out I, find out any drop IXE and divide by XE. You will get value of I. Okay, so this is our last step. Like this, you have to draw the Clark diagram of two machine system with resistance. Okay, I will revise these steps. First, with vector I as a reference, lay off Ix1, Ixe, Ire, Ix2. First step over. This you have to take at your convenient scale. You have to take at convenient scale. 1 centimeter equal to 0.1 unit or 0.2 unit. Whatever you want. According to your convenience, you can take. Then join the first and last point. Okay. Draw the vector sum A and E. Draw FG. Okay, draw this FG. Okay, perpendicular bisector, that is perpendicular bisector of AE. Extend ED until it intersect FG at G. Extend this CD up till it intersect with G. Okay, because this is our perpendicular bisector, this, and with G as the center, you have to draw arc. Next step, with G as the center, draw a circular arc AOE. Now construct part of locus of constant ratio V1 by V2 as described for the Clark diagram of a reactance system. The intersection of this locus and circular arc AOE is a point O. Now for this, if you again, the process remains same. Okay, refer lecture 7 and 8 if you are not getting this. Okay, you have to refer lecture 7 and 8 on YouTube. Okay, draw vectors e1, v1, v2 and e2, determine the scale. Now, how to calculate scale? This also I have explained in lecture 7 and 8, both lectures telling how to calculate the scale, say, how to calculate or how to determine the scale. Okay, the steps remains same, steps remain same. Okay, determine I. Now this is next step. Determine I by measuring length Ix, converting the length to the voltage and dividing by a known value of x. Suppose it is Ix, then divide by x, Ix total divide by Ix total, or Ixe divide by Xe. If it is Ix1, divide by x1, you will get value of I. Okay, we'll get value of I. Okay, now either you want to measure, or if you want to measure power factor, then you can measure. It is between voltage and current, angle between voltage and current. Okay, or you can find out steady state. This is simplest method. Steady state stability limit can be find out by Vm into I. We have to find out by this. Okay, this is convenient to find, because either you have to measure phi 2, that is little bit difficult. So by this, it will, both values will be same, Vm into I. Okay, now see here. Now here you can see, when we are considering two machine system with losses, there this angle, you can, angle between E1 and E2, angle between E1 and E2 is theta 1 2, angle between E1 and E2 is theta 1 2, E1 and E2, angle between E1 and E2 is theta 1 2, it is not 90 degree. While when we are considering lossless system, this angle is, this angle del is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, the two machine system with losses is differing by this concept. Okay, because when we are considering losses, this angle then will not equal to, steady state stability limit will not occur at del equal to 90 degree, either the smaller angle which we are considering. Okay, also it depends upon the positive resistance as well as negative resistance, the smaller value which we are considering, and this is called our the conservative criteria of stability. Okay, now this example you have to solve on graph paper. Find the steady state stability limit of a system consisting of a generator of equivalent reactance 0.6 unit connected to the infinite bus through series reactance of 1 unit and has a resistance of 0.3 unit. The terminal voltage of generator is held at V1 is 1.1 infinite bus, so V2 is 1. 1 at an angle of 0, 1.1 at an angle of theta. Okay, so this is given. Example is same which we have drawn or which we have seen in earlier lecture 7 and 8. Only thing is added this resistance 0.3. Okay, now we have to as it is single machine system, generator connected to the infinite bus. So here x2 is absent. We have to start from the, we have to start from receiving end. So x2 is absent. Okay, x2 is absent. Okay, so then what we'll do, x2 is absent. I am drawing the diagram again. This is generator reactance x1, then our resistance and reactance R plus Jx. X2 is 0, it is connected to infinite bus. Okay, so this is X1 Re plus JXe. Okay, so we have to start from receiving end. Okay, now Xe will be first, so Xe given is as 1 unit. So the scale which we have to take, 1 centimeter equal to 0.1 unit. So this may be 10 centimeter. Okay, if it is 0.2, it will be 5 centimeter. Okay, so this is our IXE. Okay, second drop is IRE. As I told, RE drop will be in phase with the current vector. So this is our IRE. So this is, as we are taking 1 centimeter equal to 0.1 unit, so it will be 3 centimeter. Okay, and this is our IRE drop. Okay, and then XE no, sorry, this is over na, x1 is we have started from the receiving end. This is x is over, r is over. Now x1 is 0.6, x1 is 0.6. So this is ix1, this is ix1. 0.6 means 6 centimeter. Now these two points we have to join. Okay, now we have to draw perpendicular bisector. Now this perpendicular bisector will intersect at F. We have to draw an arc. Okay, we have to draw an arc. So first step is over, second step is over, third step, fourth step, fifth step. Construct locus of V1 by V2, construct locus of V1 by V2. You can see lecture 7 and lecture 8 for this. Okay, if you are not getting how to calculate or how to draw V1 by V2, okay. Now join this E1, V1. Now E2 is equal to V2 as it is infinite bus. As it is infinite bus, E2 is equal to V2. Then draw a parallel line from O, which is on this CD line. Okay, it will be VM. It will be VM. Now using convenient scale, calculate E1, V1, VM, V2. Okay. Then determine I. Either you have to calculate IXE or IRE, IX1. Okay. And divide with that value, known value, IXE by XE or IX1 by X1. You will get value of I. Okay. Now measure the receiving end power factor. No need. Because we can find out steady state stability by VM into I. This is simplest method. Okay, because while measuring this phi 2, you may get error. We may get error. So that's why this, because this, if we consider, if this is our phi 2, this is our phi 2. Okay, this is angle between sending in, na? Receiving end power factor, na? So V2 and I, angle between V2 and I is phi 2. Okay, so this is V2 and I. Either you have to measure this angle, this will be our phi 2. Okay, this will be our phi 2. V2 into I into cos of phi 2 or VM into I. So V2, I, V2 you have to calculate, V2 you know, because it is one, it is infinite bus. I, we need to calculate cos of phi 2 or VM into I. Okay, now solution, this already I have given, you can note down it and you have to draw it on graph paper. Okay, here I am getting steady state stability limit as 0.74 unit. In earlier, what is the difference? In earlier, without losses, that steady state stability limit is 1.03. Okay, and here steady state stability limit is 0.74. okay, it is decreased due to losses. It is decreased due to losses. Okay, now next, multi-machine system. Okay, we have seen how to find out. Now this is our graphical method. Whatever we have seen, Clark diagram is finding out steady state stability limit of a system having resistance. Okay, can be find out by the Clark diagram. Okay, this is graphical method. This is graphical method. So it took time. Okay, and this is applicable for two machines only. When there are number of machines, then how to find out steady state stability limit is by using this criteria, that is synchronizing power coefficient. Okay, del p by del, if it is greater than 0, that means partial derivative of p with respect to del is greater than 0, the system is stable. If number of machines are there, then we have to apply this concept to each and every machine. Then if that is greater than 0, the slope is, if that slope is positive or greater than 0, the system is stable. While doing this, we have three assumptions. First assumption, the relative angular position of the remaining machines be constant. The machine which we are considering, that we'll consider, while the angular position of other machine which we are considering as a constant. that the power output of all but two machines remaining constant while angular displacement between these two are altered. Okay, suppose we are considering any machine, then angular that machine connected with the other machine, okay, that this generator connected with the motor or generator connected with the other generator, then these two machines will consider, these two machine will consider an angular displacement between these two machine will consider, while remaining the power output of remaining other machines we are considering to be constant. Third thing, that when the angular position of one machine is altered, the accompanying change of power be divided among the remaining machine in accordance with their prime mover characteristics. This no. If I am changing this generator, then whatever change I am getting, that I will divide to the other generators. Okay, whatever power output, if shaft load is increasing, then I will divide to the other. Okay, this assumptions or this thing we need to keep in mind. Okay, while calculating steady state stability limit of a multi machine system using synchronizing power coefficient. Thank you very much.